This book is certainly a valued asset for those who are already in the organization, because for all the problems that they are facing and will be facing, the answer is all there in the book. This book is extremely talking about change management, equally encouraging all readers to deal with problems and sort out issues in the organization. So I just read out the small quote what sir has mentioned. All of a sudden a noble man may fall, but his fall like that of a ball is upspringing. But the crooked who falls stays fallen calls it the flattened out fall of a lump of a clay. And this is so beautiful, because in day in and out we sometimes feel, you know, gone down, demotivated, we don't know whether we are going to come back or not, we'll be able to do good or not. But if you are good, if you are positive, then definitely there is an upspring waiting for you and you can come back. And this whole book has lots of experience which sir has shared about different organizations, which talks back how to revive back. So without taking much time, I request sir to please address our students.
Namaskar. Let me begin by first thanking Dr. R.K. Mishra. There is another very senior colleague who is here for a session and he has gone to introduce him across. He has made my task easier by mentioning a few important aspects, and I am thankful to my colleagues here, Sai Saab and the lady here. We have about an hour, a little over an hour. I would like to ask you, before I say anything, how would you like me to proceed? Broadly, there are two ways. One is that I mention a few key issues and then we have a discussion. The other is that if you have read, some of you have read some things and you want to ask any further elucidation or elaboration, what would you prefer? Please tell me, I'll proceed accordingly. The first option or the second? Second, okay. In that case, I'll just give a very quick overview and then straight away we'll have an interactive session. See, the first thing is that the credit for this book being what it is does not go to me. It goes to my co-author, Mohit Siddiqui Saab, who incidentally is also based in Hyderabad. Mr. Mohit Siddiqui, since some of you have obviously read the book, is now a private consultant. He runs a small company called Intellects Biz, and he trains, he conducts training programs mainly for corporates. Now, he has authored many books on management, and if my memory is correct, so far 25 books have been published by him. As far as I am concerned, being a civil servant, I retired just 7 months ago. I did not really have a I had the inclination, but I did not have the time to write. But those of you who have read the book will would have seen how it came about. I happen to be the CMD of Singareni Coalries Company Limited, SCCL for short. And I was looking for training of my senior colleagues. When I had joined the company, the strength was over 1,03,000 employees. That's a huge number. Out of which we had 2,800 executives. So Mr. Sharma, Chandrakant Sharma, he told me there is a gentleman called Mr. Mohit Siddiqui and we can involve him in our training. That's how I met Mr. Siddiqui, and then I was extremely, to say the least, impressed by him, and I consider it a good fortune to have known him now for 10 years. When I was leaving in 2006, and incidentally I am no longer the longest serving CMD, I am now the second longest, because my immediate successor, Mr. Narasingh Rao, he served for 5 years, 8 months. My innings is just 4 years and 11 months. But at the time I left, I was the longest serving. So to that point, the statement is factually correct. But now it will be incorrect, so you can always say second longest. Siddiqui Saab told me that Khwaja Saab, why don't you write a chapter for a book, which he was then writing, called the Pygmalion manager. I said, what is the length? She said, well, about 30, 35 pages. I said, okay, that's not a big thing. I'll contribute a chapter. So when I was working on that chapter, then he told me, you write very well. Why don't you co-author the book with me? And you write about your Singareni experience. I said, bhai, I'm a man of action. I'm not a man of words, and I can write by God's grace because I've always been fond of reading and writing. But he said, nahi, nahi, aap likhiye. Now it so happened that when I was transferred from Singareni, I was in an assignment where I had time. And that's when I wrote my part. The concepts, techniques, strategies and execution, and most of the things read out by Dr. Mishra and also by my colleague here, all belong to the contribution of Mohit Saab. So there should be no doubt in anybody's mind here that if the book is good, the credit entirely goes to Mohit Saab. I have written part two. The book, by the way, is independently written. He wrote his part, I wrote my part. But once you have completed reading the 200, and I think now in the revised edition, number of pages have come down. Originally it was 50 pages more, now it's 252. You will realize, as Dr. Irani has said, that there is good jugalbandi between us. Now those of you who are not familiar with Hindustani music or Carnatic music should know that the exact meaning of jugalbandi is being in harmony, when the music is in harmony, jugalbandi, band karna, jugalbandi. What I would like to just quickly share with you is, and then straight away we'll have an interactive session. You see, Professor Mishra mentioned a few things. First is, what is the role of books in our life? I think the best quotation which I can think of is from Mohandas Karamchand Gandhi Saab, or Gandhiji as we call him. He has said that man's best friends are books. And I would agree with it fully, because despite the technology which we all have now, we read e-books, Kindle, etc. The fact of the matter is, if you have a hard copy, and as Professor Mishra was saying, you can keep it next to your bed or next to your writing table or your phone, and some people have the bad habit of even reading in the bathroom, which I would strictly recommend against. That's not a good habit at all. But except the bathroom, you can keep it anywhere else. Any book, any article, anything that you like. And certainly I would agree with our colleague here that when you are feeling flattened and down and out, how do you motivate yourself? So if there is something you like, you can read, reread, ad infinitum, you can prefix read to it. Even if you read it 50 times, you will still discover something new, because the thought process at a given point of time will vary. You know, the person who said, why can't you step into the same river twice, is none other than Heraclitus of Greece. And he was there more than 2000 years ago. The chapter titled, if you do not know where you are going, any road will take you there, is Lord Gautam Buddha. If you know, just think of this, and you think of it after 1 year, you think of it after 10 minutes. Let me just elaborate. Why can't you step into the same river twice? Let us say this is flowing water and you step into it once. So you step in, then you step out. Now please note, the crucial word here is flowing water. After 1 minute also, or even technically after 5 seconds, if you step in again, it's not the same river, because the water has already flowed. And if you go into microorganisms, and if you go into the science of water hydrology, biology, then you know, you will appreciate how within seconds the metabolism, the physiochemical dimensions keep changing. Now go to the thought process of the person who said it. Why can't you step into the same river twice? Keep reflecting. No two situations in life are same. No 2 days in an individual's life are same. After 1 hour, I may be feeling different. I may be feeling very down, or I may be feeling a bit better. So the whole idea here is a person should understand the inherent dynamics in any process. Any road will take you there. This is the problem with all of us in today's world. You know, one of the famous favorite pastimes of human beings is, there was a book written in late 1960s by a medical doctor, Dr. Thomas Harris, and it became an all-time bestseller. And after I give the title of the book, I would like to know whether anybody in this room has read it, page to page. The title of the book is, I'm okay, you are okay. How many people in this room have read it page to page, not glanced through it in some book review? None. Now this book became a bestseller. So if you read this book, I suggest you read it. It may be there in your library. Otherwise, madam, please get a copy. This is linked to, if you do not know where you are going, any road will take you there. What it means is, we live in times where we are completely almost victims and perpetuators and collaborators of technological domination over us. Today, most of you must be in your 20s. Today, when I look at people like you who are in their 20s or maybe early 30s, some of you, I feel very sorry for you, because I can guarantee you my memory will be 10 times better than yours. If you want to test it, bring any text. 5 minutes we'll take. Then we'll go outside the room and we'll ask you to reproduce what you read in that 5 minutes. I'll be able to do it much better than you. I'll give you a telephone number to memorize. You will not be able to memorize. I'll be able to do it. Why? Because I am not a victim of technology. When I was young, we used to use this gray matter here. We never used this. Now you are all victims of this. And you know, 4 years ago, I was talking to the IAS probationers in the National Academy of Administration at Mussoorie. At that time, I was holding the charge of Special Secretary, Ministry of Environment and Forests, Government of India. And it was a long session, 2.5 hours, and there was a break in between. So I told the probationers that I normally don't speak more than 40 minutes. So I won't even speak the first 1 hour, 15 minutes. I'll stop after 45 minutes. And then we can have the entire session for discussions. Even before I could complete that 45, 50 minutes, I found some probationers sleeping and others looking down all the time. And suddenly, the faculty people who were with me on the stage, they got very angry. I forget the name of the gentleman. And he said, 1 minute, sir, please stop. So I stopped. I was wondering what's happened. And then he named 4 or 5 probationers, because he knew. He said, X, Y, Z, 5, 6. I think there were 1 or 2 lady officers and 3 or 4 gentlemen officers. Please get up. And they just stood up. And he said, get out of the hall. And then he told me at lunch, charge sheets were issued to those people. You know why? They were using their mobile phones. And the academy rules do not permit use of mobile phones in the classroom. So then he told me over lunch, sir, will you believe it? These IAS officers who are not yet in the field, they are undergoing training. They're so indisciplined. How can they enforce discipline on others when they themselves are indisciplined? He said, the academy has a rule. We confiscate the mobile phone if it is found inside a classroom. They don't mind. They pay out of the salaries. We fine them. And he said, then we even punish them. Now this is an example which I think is very relevant to the generation which is in front of me. You see, you people have become victims. Your fingers just can't, you know, be at peace. And when your fingers can't be at peace, your mind certainly cannot be calm. The role of books is to soothe you, to make you think. And, you know, like the serenity of any beautiful place, a soliloquy. How many people in this room know the meaning of the word soliloquy? Please raise your hands. You know, sir? No, madam, you are not only the... What is the meaning, sir?
Speaking to
Precisely. Speaking to oneself. How many of us speak to ourselves? So, the main thing I would like to say is, not only this book, it may be good, bad and different, that's a different matter, it doesn't matter. Any book that you read, any material that you read, please have a clear-cut thought process in your mind so that you know which road you are taking and where you want to go. Please go ahead. I normally stick to my timings. So whoever would like to ask anything is welcome, and that's the reason I am before you. Tell me the page. Otherwise, tell me. I mean, since I am supposed to be the author, I should be knowing.
The only way to understand the flow of change is to change the point of view.
Okay. That's why I wanted to write on the board. I am giving you a framework which is called the Myers-Briggs framework, and you can just note it down. Vision, mission, structure. Next word is execution. Next is monitoring. I am not a teacher, therefore my handwriting or habit of writing on the board is not so good, so pardon that. And the last is evaluation. I don't know how many will be able to see evaluation. So vision, mission, structure, monitoring. After structure, execution, monitoring and evaluation. Now, how many people in this room have heard of Viktor Frankl and logotherapy? None. Okay. Because that is in response to your question. What's your name, please?
Samaita.
Samaita. Samay se. Vakt. Vakt ki awaz.